this week has got to be Big D, the loneliest man in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll call him Mr. Lonely.
Once again to All American. I'm Gorilla Monsoon along
and I'm the extremely well-muscled Johnny Polo.
You are not.
I am too. Look at him, Orange.
Plenty of ramifications, as you saw, coming out of the Heartbreak Hotel with Mr. Paul Bearer.
Wait a second. Before we go any further, that nonsense he was spewing, what a bunch of hooey. Does anybody believe anything that he says? Boy, wait till you see it. There's no way I can believe any of that.
You don't believe any of it?
No.
You've always been a disbeliever.
I certainly have.
What a blockbuster of a program we have for you here this week, folks. We'll be taking a look at the Made in the USA, Lex Luger.
Talking about taking a look at Lex Luger, Ted DiBiase is taking a look at him, and I think Ted DiBiase wants to make him a part of the corporation.
He's got about two chances of getting Lex.
Which two?
Slim and none.
I know a guy named Slim once.
And we'll also see in our very special own feature here on All American, Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper's Bottom Line.
Wait, now speaking of bottom lines, I am going to have an improved bottom line. It's going to affect my own personal bottom line. It's going to be a big surprise, but I'll tell you about it later.
I don't like surprises from you.
Why?
Kicking things off right here this week, Native American Tatanka in action. Let's get to it.
You'll be surprised.
Welcome back, everyone. We'd like to thank you for joining us this week. See that Native American
Tatanka. Move over, Lane. I'm back. No. Another one bagged in tags.
Tana, I must tell you off the bat, even though I hate to say this, it's the truth. The Undertaker is as awesome as ever.
Did you ever have any doubt in your mind? Yes, as a matter of fact, you did. Well, doubt no more. Oh, doubting one, the Undertaker belongs to me.
Let me tell you right now, put that fistful of dollar bills, or they're not dollars, they're hundreds. Put those back in your pocket right now. Don't be flashing that in front of my face if you don't mind. Tatanka has been flashing here himself in the World Wrestling Federation, and he's starting things off in a flash here against the Black Phantom. Tatanka wasting no time. He is looking good. You know, Tatanka is going to be a busy superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation coming up. He's got some big matches, Ted DiBiase.
I'll say he's got some big matches. Next week on Wrestling Superstars, he will face The Undertaker. Now, I won't take anything away from Tatanka. He's a fantastic athlete. I've never said that he wasn't. But his rapid rise in the World Wrestling Federation is fixing to come to a screeching halt.
Well, that remains to be seen, Million Dollar Man. And you know, when you say The Undertaker, it brings to mind a thought that I had earlier about Paul Bearer. You know, Tim, Paul Bearer claims that he has regained contact with The Undertaker. What do you have to say about that?
Well, we saw The Undertaker this week on Superstars with the Million Dollar Man. So you saw him in person. Paul Bearer gets on Heartbreak Hotel and says he's regained contact with The Undertaker, when in fact he already said that the trail had gone cold. I don't think he knows what he's got. That's what I think, Stan Lane.
Well, I'm not disclaiming the fact that I saw The Undertaker, but I'm saying, Ted, that Paul Bearer said that he has regained contact. Whoa, nice move. He has regained contact with The Undertaker, so maybe Paul Bearer is talking to The Undertaker behind your back, Million Dollar Man.
That's ridiculous, Lane. Well, he said a long time ago he had lost the trail. The trail had grown cold. He's just trying to buy time. He's trying to keep from losing faith, that's all.
I don't know. Wow, nice vertical suplex by the Native American. Tatanka, in addition, Ted, of course, to that big matchup against The Undertaker, Tatanka will meet Double J, Jeff Jarrett, this Monday night on Raw. And what a tremendous matchup that will be.
Well, it seems to me Tatanka has got a lot in store. He's got a long road ahead of him. I wonder how tall he is.
He's 6 feet tall. Did you hear the sound of those chops?
I'm just measuring him for the body bag.
Give me a break. Tatanka looking good here against the Black Phantom. You know, that score that he has with IRS, the tax man, has still not been settled either. He will never, as long as he lives, forget what IRS did when he desecrated Tatanka's sacred headdress. And then, you know, Tatanka just may meet IRS on that red-hot summer sizzler tour, DiBiase.
Did you ever stop to thank Stan Lane and remember that me and IRS are still associated together, that Tatanka didn't pay the gift tax, and that he is facing The Undertaker? Doesn't it all kind of blend in there? You think he got his feathers plucked before? Just wait till The Undertaker gets a hold of him.
Oh, gut-wrench suplex. Ted DiBiase, you telling me that you had something to do with this, the headdress being desecrated?
What I'm telling you, Stan Lane, is that IRS and I are still business associates, and that because Tatanka didn't pay the gift tax, whether it's IRS personally or The Undertaker, our corporation will see that he pays.
Well, if that's the case, then, when Tatanka gets through with IRS and teaches him a lesson, perhaps you'd like to teach the $1 Million Man a lesson as well if you were involved with that.
Well, he's got a long way to go before he reaches me. There's Nikolai Volkoff, there's The Undertaker, there's Bam Bam Bigelow, and, you know, I got my eye on Lex Luger.
You know, speaking of Nikolai Volkoff, you know, some of your purchases may not be all that great. The 1-2-3 Kid beat Nikolai Volkoff on Monday Night Raw, see?
Come on, Lane.
You may be able to buy and purchase some superstars, but sometimes these purchases may not pan out, $1 Million Man.
The 1-2-3 Kid was getting beat by Nikolai Volkoff, and he faked a knee injury and caught the cheap victory. That way, hey, look what happened after that.
Yeah, look what happened after that. The 1-2-3 Kid signed a title match against the WWF champion, Bret the Hitman Hart.
That's not what I'm talking about. Volkoff jumped the 1-2-3 Kid and beat him up. Then Virgil stuck his nose in there, and he got beat up too.
And then the man made the USA came down and cleaned house.
Hey, wait a minute. He was just auditioning for me. He was just trying to show me his stuff.
Well, Tatanka is showing the Black Phantom his stuff right now. The Native American has gone on the warpath.
Well, he better save a little bit. Actually, he better save a lot, because The Undertaker's going to send him to the happy hunting ground.
Well, the Black Phantom just may have gone on his last hunt, because that is the Renegade Drop delivered by Tatanka. The Native American looking good this week. He's got a lot facing him in the future. Double J, The Undertaker, IRS, they're all waiting in line for the Native American Tatanka. And Ted DiBiase, you better flash a lot of money in front of The Undertaker if you want him to take it to Tatanka.
Can you believe it, folks? What a tremendous athlete this Native American Tatanka is. Just an testament to what perseverance, what tremendous conditioning can do for it. You could have been like that, Johnny Paul.
I am like that, Gorilla. Oh. You know, I'll tell you what, I'll give the Native American credit. He looked good. In fact, he looked real good. But what's he going to do against the guy, say, like Ted DiBiase's Undertaker?
Oh, that's our feature matchup next week right here on All American. A match that people will be talking about for a long time to come, I'm sure.
Speaking about a long time, Gorilla, I'm talking about a new feature that has something to do with matches from a long time ago. The WWF Memory Lane match, an All-American exclusive.
That innovation starts right here this week. We're going to take you back into the archives of the World Wrestling Federation, show you some tremendous matchups from years gone by. We're going to kick it off with 1985 WrestleMania 1 Madison Square Garden, $15,000 slam match. Andre the Giant trying to get 15 grand out of the big guy, John Studd. But coming up right now, a big guy himself. Yes, I'm referring to Hot Rod Rowdy Roddy Piper and his Bottom Line.
And then later on, we'll have my own personal improved Bottom Line.
I'm afraid of that.
I've seen advertisement on the WWF. They're talking about the old and the new. And I want to say something about that, too. You know, with guys and athletes that are, you would say, the older generation, they never want the new generation to do any good because they're jealous. They want to be the guys that said, hey, we did it. Nobody else is ever going to be able to follow us. I ran the most touchdowns. I made the most baskets. I won the most wrestling matches. You know what? I'm proud of the new generation. I think the new generation is smarter than we were. I think they're faster. I think that they're better wrestlers. I think they learn a lot from us. I think the older generation made a lot of mistakes that the press capitalized on and that everybody else did. But bottom line is, I'm doggone proud of the new generation. So don't you guys let anybody get you down. I think The Undertaker is under contract to an underhanded moneymonger. Laughs like a hyena. Problem with this one is, he's got a right to laugh this time. Because he sure pulled a fast one. You know, for being such a dumb guy. You know, let me tell you something about DiBiase. This is a true story, somebody may not know. When he's one heck of an athlete. When he played football, though, they had to have a special helmet made to fit that cranium. Yes, kind of, it's kind of oblong with a kind of a pointed top. You know what's that? Bottom line. Shawn Michaels. I mean, a great wrestler and all that, but, you know, the thing with the hair, you know, and the thing, and you're coming down the stairs and into the camera. What is this, the WWS version of Madonna? Ah, bottom line.
Flip the hamburgers over. We'll be right back with Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Connor, let me take this opportunity to remind you about the big heart attack tour headed over there exclusively in the UK. It all starts mid-September, Wednesday the 14th, continues right on through to the 17th. Well, big news is that British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith got so bent out of shape after seeing what went down at the King of the Ring, jumped on the horn, called up President Jack Tunney and said, I want to be reinstated, and here's the match I want to be in. I want to take my brother-in-law, Bret the Hitman Hart, as a partner and face Jim the Anvil Neidhart and his brother-in-law, The Rocket, who now wants to be referred to as the King of Hearts. Well, we're going to hear about that in just mere moments here on the program because we have the King's Court coming up with the Anvil and with his
King of Hearts. Yeah, I like the King of Hearts. He's cool. In fact, I'll tell you what, the British Bulldog being a part of this heart attack tour, that's surprising. But you want to know what the big surprise is, Gorilla? It's my big surprise. And up. Wait, stand up.
Stand up.
Get up.
Gotta get up.
Get up. Hit the music.
What music?
Money, money, money.
Oh, no.
Money.
You invited him here?
Oh, yeah.
Why didn't you?
What do you say, Jerry? How you doing? Hey. Limousines outside.
Limos.
Champagne's on ice.
Champagne.
My personal jet is fueled up and ready to go. That's right. And here are a lot of reasons for you to go have a good time. Have at it.
That's the news, and I'm out of here.
What do you mean you're out of here? Wait a minute.
Have a good time, Johnny. Gorilla Monsoon, your new co-host on All America.
Oh, I don't think so. Wait, do we have a producer? Yes.
No. Where's don't bother calling him. You're not going to find him. You know, as of late here in the World Wrestling Federation, I've been a very busy guy.
I know that.
Just a few weeks ago, I bought the services of one Nikolai Volkov.
You certainly did.
And then after that, I acquired the services, much to everyone's dismay, of one Undertaker. And most recently, I bought, at a very lucrative deal, one Bam Bam Bigelow. So you might say the corporation is growing rapidly.
So what does that mean?
What I needed was a platform, a place to show my wares, so to speak.
Not and this program.
I couldn't think of a better place than All American, right here on Sky.
No, not here.
Oh, yes.
Well, we'll see about that. Huh, I suppose you got eyes on these other two guys that are coming up right now. Well, let's show the King's Court with the Anvil and the Rocket. I can't call him the King.
And the King of the Ring, and the chips are really down to him, man. At 6'10", Diesel, the face, who is he called? Anvil, his old partner. So I went down there, and I made sure the job got done. I made sure that he would hold on to that belt for one reason and one reason only, so that Owen Hart will be the rightful owner. Reality, exactly how I said it would be.
and that's to take you, Brett, and beat you for the World Wrestling Federation title. And you know I can do it. I know I can do it. And everybody out here knows what the King of Hearts is capable of doing. And Brett, you're shaking in your boots. You're scared to death of your little brother. But Brett, give me one shot, King. I only need one more chance. And you will not only be looking at the King of Hearts, but the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Well, folks, regardless of what the Rocket and that lunatic had to say, the Hitman is still the WWF champion.
That's right, Gorilla. That's right. That's exactly right. Their strategy, you have to admit, is working perfectly. They accomplished what they set out to accomplish. Number one, they preserved the title. Bret the Hitman Hart is still the World Wrestling Federation champion, enabling Owen now to come along and defeat his brother one more time and become World Wrestling Federation champion. Number two, they have psychologically deflated the Hitman. I mean, he doesn't know whether he's even worthy of being a champion at this point. Diesel got him up, jackknifed him, covered him. He's not sure he could have kicked out. He may have lost the match right there and the title.
Well, I'll have to agree with you, DiBiase, on that point. Hitman could be having some sleepless nights wondering whether he could or could not have kicked out of the jackknife, but you two beauties are in deep trouble. You've got the Hitman to deal with now. You've got Diesel against you. Diesel not too happy with either one of you. And how about the bad guy, Razor Ramon? Is he thrilled with these two?
Gorilla, they've got the whole Hart family against them. They're the black sheep of the family. But Owen Hart wins the World Wrestling Federation title, it's all worth it.
All sheep, Mr. DiBiase, sooner or later, have to be sheared. Remember that. Coming up right now,
my next acquisition, Lex Luger.
The producer's with who? Where?
You're not going to find the producer. You're not going to find the director.
You wrote some more
checks. There were three bottles of champagne in that limousine. They're with Polo. They're out of here. You're stuck with me.
We'll see about that. Folks, I want to show you something that went down just this weekend on WWF Mania. The contest winner for the co-host to be with my pal, the Totster, was Jason Taruskin. Now, here's a kid that was really on the ball. He earned the right to be co-host. Oh, he didn't buy his way.
But he's not having as much fun as me.
I'm not having any fun. Roll the footage, please.
Open the door. Look at this. The kid's dream has come true. He gets the hat. He gets the welcome, a round of applause, and now, check out the sign. It's like from a professional sign company. Gets Todd Pettengill and
Jason Taruskin, the co-host winner.
Yeah, you're getting good, kid.
Thanks.
No problem. And Jason and I, everybody in the World Wrestling Federation, oh, I thought maybe that page was for you. Some big producer out there saw you.
I like that.
Loved you.
I like
put
that.
Put your name in lights.
I like that.
But it wasn't.
Enough of that, kid. He's no million-dollar man. But then again, who is? And while Gorilla Monsoon is running down the street trying to catch my limousine, let's take a look at my next piece of property, Lex Luger.
Ready for the red, white, and blue Lex Luger made in the USA. Coming down that aisle, get ready.
Well, where is he?
Oh, besides the back talking to the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, that would be very, very famous.
Here
he is. Listen to this crowd and enjoy the light show. All right.
Look at that tremendous body.
Thank you. I didn't think you noticed, Gorilla.
No, the body on left.
Oh, okay. He's got a good one, too. Yeah, he does.
Tremendous action coming up with Made in the USA, Lex Luger.
Good looking, so when the lights come on, you'll notice me.
Ah, here we go.
Lex Luger getting ready for battle.
What a focused individual. We know what Crush did to him. We know that he was denied an opportunity to become WWF King of the Ring. And Crush, of course, responsible for that, Randy.
Yeah, but he busted the party at the King of the Ring tournament, didn't he?
Boy, did he ever.
Can't tell him what he can't do. A little bit of rebel inside of Lex Luger. I hope not too much for the $1 Million Man, though.
Guys in the know said that Crush and Yokozuna would leave the King of the Ring as the new WWF Tag Champions, but Lex had other ideas.
It didn't happen.
Sign a headlock now by Lex.
Big tackle by Lex Luger. Looks in great shape.
Beautiful shoulder block.
Gorilla, what do you think? Ted DiBiase, the $1 Million Man, hasn't made an appearance. You think he's satisfied with the possible acquisition of Bam Bam Bigelow? We don't know if that to be true or not true, but what do you think about $1 Million Man Ted DiBiase?
Well, I don't think he's satisfied, Randy. He came here for one specific thing in mind. That was to talk to Lex Luger. We haven't seen him do that.
Maybe the $1 Million Man can't keep a thought. He said that last week that he wanted to talk to Lex Luger. Maybe he forgot.
Well, maybe he did and we don't know about it.
Well, I'll tell you what, if he doesn't come out here, I'll be glad. Beautiful. Because 1 week before July 4th weekend, I'm saying that the red, white, and blue Lex Luger's not going to sell out anyway.
Boy, I concur with that. Our country decided a long time ago.
Look at this.
I guess he hasn't had an opportunity.
The Macho Vine and the Gorilla Vine both didn't work that time. Look at this.
He's standing right in the entranceway here. But you can't talk to anybody from there.
This is incredible. What is going on?
He's just looking.
He's looking and leaving? I hope so.
Well, maybe the deal's already been made, Randy.
But maybe it hasn't. Remember last week with the 1-2-3 Kid versus Nikolai Volkoff, when the Kid beat Volkoff and then Virgil came down, and then all of a sudden Lex Luger came down.
What a shot!
It was a great shot, but are you listening to me?
I'm listening.
You remember what DiBiase, the look in his eye, when he was looking at Luger, was more of admiration rather than being mad at him.
Well, that's definitely a bad backbreaker here by Lex. He say we're going to see it. We're going to see the rack.
I like him put $1 Million Man Ted DiBiase in the rack.
Oh, here it comes. You know, I'm not too sure that Lex even saw DiBiase standing back there in the entranceway.
Well, I'm not sure that if you're not entirely wrong or you're entirely right. So I'm middle of the road and can't give you an opinion.
Lex.
I'm confused. One thing for sure, Lex Luger is a great superstar in the new generation World Wrestling Federation. And that's thumbs up. Check
this
it out.
This guy, Macho Man, would never sell out.
That's a complete contradictory statement to what you just said before, but okay, I'll believe that.
Lex Luger, the man made in the USA. Soon to be Lex Luger, the man refined by the $1 Million Man, Ted DiBiase. And is going to go international. As you just saw... Why, Monsoon, you're breathing a little heavy there. What's the matter?
Almost caught that limo.
You were chasing my limo.
Hey, they threw a bomb down. Who was in there?
There was Johnny Polo and the director and the producer. I told you I'm here to stay. Like I was saying, Lex Luger, all he needs is a little guidance and all the resources which I have, and he has all the potential in the world.
I suppose you think that you can make him a household name all over the world.
Internationally.
I think he could get there without you. You've got two chances of getting him, slim and none, just like I told that other goof.
Don't bank on it.
Well, coming up when we come back in mere moments. Boy, that hurt. That bottle hit me right there. We're going to go to the Heartbreak Hotel, so please stay with us. You thought it was funny, huh?
To say that he couldn't get a woman or a friend with a fistful of 50s would be a grave understatement.
It is you, Ross.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Heartbreak Hotel was tailor-made for my next guest, for his poor heart has been broken in a million pieces. Ladies and gentlemen, the former manager of The Undertaker, Paul Bearer.
former. Well, I don't know about that. I think we may hear a little bit more about this whole mysterious situation. And I'll tell you something. The Tonka and the Undertaker right here next week. And I wonder who will be in the Undertaker's corner. Will it be
that? Look. You better hope that never happens to him. Because if he does, then you'll be the ugliest man on earth.
Why don't you apologize
hey,
for that?
Shut up.
This ought to be good. I know there's gonna. I got a feeling there's gonna be a big announcement here.
What if the ground was cold this morning when he crawled out of it?
Oh, what were the earnings?
You talk about a sad-looking cuss. You, my friend, look like death. What does somebody do to cut you down? How do you know when you're not looking good? Because, Jack, you're doing it. Paul Bear.
You look very dejected.
You've had a rough streak as of late, haven't you, my friend? The Million Dollar Man said for weeks and weeks that he could find The Undertaker. You claim to be able to find The Undertaker. But alas, while all this was going on, The Undertaker managed to elude just about everyone. But finally, one man here in the World Wrestling Federation had what it took, had the resources, if you know what I mean, to bring The Undertaker back to the World Wrestling Federation. And you know, the more I think about it, it's only fitting that the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, brought The Undertaker back, because he's the man who originally brought The Undertaker to the World Wrestling Federation. I mean, let's face it, when you took over the helm of The Undertaker, his career went down, Captain Kirk. I'm talking 6 feet down. The last time we saw The Undertaker, he was getting dropped in an oversized box. Lo and behold, who brings him back to the World Wrestling Federation? Not Paul Bearer, the man who originally brought him to the World Wrestling Federation, the Million Dollar Man.
Tell it like it is, Sean.
Well, Mr. Michaels.
Told you it was.
I want you to understand. And you, Ted DiBiase, I want you to understand that I have regained contact with
what? Man.
Wait 1 second. What you're telling me and all the World Wrestling Federation fans is that now you have spoken to The Undertaker, correct?
No, that's not correct. I didn't say I've spoken to my Undertaker.
What does that mean exactly?
I don't know, but his face looks like the moon from about 3 miles out.
Now, if you have had this contact with The Undertaker, you must know that next week on Monday Night Raw, The Undertaker will be in action. And right here on World Wrestling Federation Superstars, The Undertaker will be in action against the Native American Tatanka, correct?
Right.
For once, you are correct. And yes, I will be at Monday Night Raw. Yes, to get a great side view of Ted DiBiase and The Undertaker. Because, you know, I don't think Ted DiBiase really understands what he actually has. Oh, no, you must remember the final words of my Undertaker. He said he would never rest in peace.
I got news for you, Paul Bearer. I am so sick of listening to you and The Undertaker talking about resting in peace. Talk is cheap. Coming from a guy who loves the smell of embalming fluid in the morning, I say you don't have it, and me and Dee don't buy it.
Yeah, what do you think of that? Well, hey, what is that?
this. I don't like this at all. Where are the lights turn? Boy, what's the deal? My gosh, it's like a tumor. Oh, no, stage is shaking. I'm getting out of here.
Wait a minute. Get back here, Lawler. What is going on here?
Wait a minute. If Diesel and Sean's leaving, I'm leaving too.
Well, don't leave me here by myself.
Where are the lights?
Oh, my. This is, look at the mirror's shaking. The whole place is shaking. I don't like this at all. I don't like it either. I'm out of here.
There you have it, folks. Paul Bearer unequivocally stating he has made direct contact with the Undertaker. You didn't want to hear that, did you? Are you looking for the door? It's over there.
This place is terrible. What's terrible? Who designed this set?
You did. Your taste is all in your mouth.
This is horrible. Nice. It's got potential.
Why are you ignoring the subject?
What are you talking about?
You didn't want to hear what Paul Bearer had to say, did you?
What? What was that?
What was that? He has made contact with the Undertaker. Is it your Undertaker?
Monsoon. Paul Bearer also specifically said he has not spoken to the Undertaker.
Well, what kind of contact did he make? It was a play on words.
I have no idea. Look, the Undertaker is back at home. He's with the Million Dollar Man. He has seen the green, so to speak. He's happy. He's mine.
Seen the green? Talk about seeing things. Did you see? Well, you weren't watching, but there was electricity and everything in the air. A cosmic happening was going on at the Heartbreak Hotel. Heartbreak Hotel will never be the same again.
Cheap trick.
Trick?
Tap into the future. Experience the new WWF generation.
The new generation is indeed alive and well here in the World Wrestling Federation. But right now, folks, we're going to take a step back in time and show you part of the old generation of the World Wrestling Federation. The location was Madison Square Garden, 1985. WrestleMania 1, big $15,000 challenge, slam match. Big John Studd, of course, at that time, part of the World Wrestling Federation, challenged Andre the Giant, saying, Andre, if you can slam me inside the ring in Madison Square Garden, Bobby the Brain Heenan will be more than happy to hand you 15 grand. But, Andre, if I slam you, you must retire once and for all from the World Wrestling Federation. Well, all you got to do to Andre is say, hey, this is a challenge.
$15,000, chump change.
Are you kidding?
You know what?
To Heenan, that's like 100 grand.
This is a great segment, Monsoon. I'm going to buy this segment.
Everything is not for sale, DiBiase.
Everything, Monsoon, is for sale, and everybody's got a price, including you.
Oh, please. Old generation time here on All American. Let's take you back to the Big Apple, 1985. Boy, is this going to be interesting and exciting. A new innovation here on All American starting this week. And every week we will delve into the archives of the World Wrestling Federation and take a look at some of the great matches of the past. Here we're taking you back to 1985, WrestleMania 1, Madison Square Garden, as we take a look at Andre the Giant in a $15,000 slam match against Studd. Madison Square Garden was the location of WrestleMania 1 and this $15,000 slam match. Of course, that's not a whole lot of money for you, DiBiase.
Chump change, Gorilla.
Chump change, huh? Wasn't chump change to Bobby the Brain Heenan, I'll tell you that.
Now, well, consider the source.
Well, the original deep pockets.
And short arms.
Andre had control during most of this matchup, and Andre, at that time, right on top of his game as we look over the shoulder of the Weasel.
Andre the Giant, in his prime, like you said, Gorilla, was usually in control all of the time. I mean, look at the size of the man, 7 feet four, 476 pounds. That's a lot of beef. And he could put it, it's just like, and I'm sure you can identify with this, where does a 400-pound gorilla sleep?
Well, any place he so desires.
That's right.
Of course, Andre could fluctuate 30 or 40 pounds in a day just on what he had for lunch. But he really did a job here on Big John Studd.
You know, Andre and I, we did some business together.
Yeah, you certainly did. I remember that very well.
He helped me gained the World Wrestling Federation title.
He did. He literally handed it to you. Put it in your grubby little hand.
Hey, thank you, Andre.
The first in our memory lane matches. We will be bringing you one of these every week here on All American. Next week, we got a real beauty. You're going to love it. The blindfold match. You remember that, DiBiase?
Yes, I do. I believe that was Jake the Snake Roberts and
Rick Martel
at WrestleMania 7 in Los Angeles.
What a classic that was.
The blind leading the blind.
Well, so to speak, it was. Oh, Andre was devastating with those chops, those reverse knife edges. Big John Studd had second thoughts about this after the match began, and he's asking for some help right now from the outside, but there is no timeout in there.
Gorilla, were you ever on the receiving end of one of those chops?
Oh, on a number of occasions, yes. And I was also Andre's partner on a number of occasions. Oh, here goes the slam attempt. Andre planted him. There's $15,000 worth. Andre looking for the bread right now. Let me have it.
Like I said, a man who appreciated the value of a dollar.
And Andre gonna reward everyone at ringside here as he literally throws the money away. Look at the brain. He went bananas. Don't forget, next week, another memory lane match right here. Folks, hope you all enjoyed our first ever Memory Lane match. Next week, another classic for you right here on All American. The Memory Lane match will be direct from WrestleMania 7, Los Angeles, California. The blindfold match. Jake the Snake Roberts taking on the model Rick Martel.
Wow, the blind leading the blind. Kind of like you and Polo hosting this show.
Serious. And when we come back, folks, it'll be the Doinkster taking on
my good friend and personal accountant, IRS.
Is he still on the payroll?
Of course.
Don't you dare. Passionate crowd on its feet and in anticipation of what a matchup this is going to be. Earl of Monsoon along with the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, who obviously couldn't buy your way out of this, could you?
Out of what?
Out of having to be here to do this match with me.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, if I could, I would. I can't stand this guy and that little goof that's following him around.
Well, you hired that other guy, Bam Bam Bigelow. He's got a little goof that's with him.
Well, the little goof won't be at ringside.
Oh.
Wait, you talking about Luna?
I'm talking about Luna.
She's not a little goof.
Oh, I didn't say that. You did.
That's his main squeeze.
Oh. Well, she bought and paid for it, too?
We had a very nice settlement. Yes, we did.
Oh. DC. I understand as part of that settlement, you have to pick up the tab for the wedding.
The chump change. Oh. Hush, quiet.
Oh, please.
Tag team.
You tell him, Irwin.
Your former tag team partner.
And my present personal friend and accountant.
Well, you guys have a lot in common.
Well, what's that?
You both got beat on Monday Night Raw by the 1-2-3 Kid.
All right, that's enough, Gorilla.
Well, isn't that true?
You know, I could buy this company.
I didn't tell a lie, did I?
You could be working for me.
Oh. Well, nice shoulder block by the Doinkster. DiBiase, obviously upset. Slam all of beauty. What tremendous wrestling techniques by the Doinkster. Of course, you don't want to take anything away from Irwin.
That's all right, Irwin. Just get it together, man.
He's a little beside himself right now. Probably stand a better chance against Sting.
Hey.
Oh.
Yeah, don't even pay any attention to him. See, he's doing that on purpose. He's trying to distract you.
You know, I'm a little confused, DiBiase. Did I not just see and hear about Paul Bearer being on the Heartbreak Hotel and claiming that he has, in fact, been in contact with The Undertaker?
Well, Paul Bearer was on Heartbreak Hotel, and he said a lot of things, but he didn't show anybody anything. I have been out here in plain view with The Undertaker. The Undertaker is under the supervision of yours truly, the Million Dollar Man.
Oh, nice sunset here!
Hey,
two count out, couldn't get him. What? Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Anyway,
there is a match going on, you know.
Anyway,
go ahead.
Paul Bearer says that he has made contact with The Undertaker.
You're calling him a liar.
Yes, I am. What I'm saying is, I have The Undertaker. What he has, I have no idea. Whatever he's dug up, so to speak, is beyond me. He says that I don't know what I'm dealing with. I always know what I'm dealing with. I'm the million-dollar man. I don't think he knows what he's dealing with.
Dug up? Is that the terminology I heard you? Dug up?
Yeah, I thought it fit. Good
to know. Great. Pendulum has swung in this one. It is now Irwin in control. Nice reverse chin lock and a lot of help there, too. Abdominal stretch now. Watch Irwin. He's very close to the ropes here. Likes to use some. Oh, there it is.
There you go. That's it, Irwin. That's it.
You condone that cheating, don't you?
You call it what you want.
I call it cheating.
Take every advantage you can get. That's it. Yeah, Irwin.
Hey, referee being distracted here by Dink. Not a good idea, Dink. Get down.
He better get down. I'm going to leave here and go get him.
Quite a conglomerate you are putting together, Mr. DiBiase.
That's
quite
right.
A corporation indeed.
The corporation is exactly that, and it is growing.
You have a health plan?
Yeah, stick with me and you'll stay healthy.
Oh, well.
Real simple. I have Nikolai Volkov. I have the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Oh, here, hooks the leg, Irwin. No. Very too close. Hey, you're supposed to break that, ref.
I've even got my eyes on Lex Luger.
Well, that's about the only thing you'll have on Lex Luger.
What do you mean?
You got about two chances of signing him.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Slim and nut.
Well, don't write checks you can't cash, Gorilla. And don't count your chickens before they hatch.
I deal in cash most of the time. Very seldom right checks.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I heard that.
Reverse chin lock here by the tax man, Irwin.
You know, we might have something in common after all.
Who, did you and the tax man?
Me and
you.
You
and you.
Yeah, you said you deal in cash.
Nice block there. Scheisser got rammed right in there. Top turnbuckle.
Come on, Irwin.
Irish whip here. Look out. Oh, beautiful clothesline. Could be the beginning of the end here.
Come on, Irwin.
Couple of big right hands. Suplex coming up. Well delivered. Over for the cover.
Come on, kick out.
No, he couldn't get it. Close, but no cigar.
You got to get up pretty early to get it on Irwin.
Two-sport All-American at Syracuse University. And now he's just getting rammed one part into the other. Oh, no. Well, that was a little bit telegraphed there.
Nice shot.
Look out, the big
road. Hey, you see that?
Hey, good job, Dink.
Come on. Get him.
Take a hug.
Can you believe that? Can you believe that?
Oh, no.
Yes. Go ahead, hit him. Hey. Oh, look out. Turn around.
Oh, off the apron with a double axe handle.
That's not fair.
The Doinster nailed it.
That's two against one, Monsoon.
That's a one and a half against one.
Well, whatever.
Irish whip here by Doink. Oh, belly-to-belly suplex.
No.
Hooks the leg.
Kick out.
Oh, was that close.
He's giving it all he can give, and he's still it. Hey, what's he doing?
Dink is under the ring. Oh, small package here by Irwin. He got it. Holy mackerel.
Your winner.
Hey, wait a minute. What was he doing under the ring with the briefcase? Hey, wait a minute. This looks like a setup.
Something down here.
Irwin, no. Don't open it.
Irwin perhaps smelling a rat here.
Oh, no. You wouldn't do anything, would you, little coot? Irwin, don't do it.
Look down.
Leave it alone.
Hey. Obviously not Irwin's case. Look at him. He's out of shape.
One of these days, Monsoon. One of these days.
A little flash powder indeed.
Remember, he who laughs last, laughs best.
Well, I thought he who laughs last is a fool for waiting so long.
Just about out of time, folks, here on this edition of All American. Just enough time left for me to tell you once more about the big heart attack tour, headed exclusively over there to you folks in the UK. It all kicks off Wednesday, September 14th in London. Big Ben will be chiming for sure. And then Thursday, the 15th of September, on to Aberdeen. And get this, Friday, September 16th, we'll be in Hull. And then on the 17th, that's a Saturday, we'll be in Birmingham. It is the big heart attack tour. DiBiase, are you still here?
What are you looking for?
Of course I'm still here.
Looking for the door. It's over there.
I'm taking notes, Monsoon. I'm starting my refurbishing of this place.
I thought you paid someone to do that menial kind of stuff.
Well, I do, but I'm just getting a head start on it.
Oh.
You know, this place has got a lot of potential. Kind of like Lex Luger. It's got a lot of potential, but all he needs and all this place needs is my resources
and my expertise.
You honestly think that you've got what it takes to acquire Lex Luger's service?
You know I do.
What does that mean?
That means I've
got... Money buys everything? Is that what you're trying to say?
Everything, Monsoon.
There's some things don't have a price tag on them, you know.
Everything's got a price tag, Monsoon.
For
instance? Including the audio man.
No, not...
Hit the music!
No, not that, little rummy! I don't want to hear that music! Knock it off! Who told you to do that?
Everybody's got a price.